Now, I hope you guys don't mind. I just want to teach tonight. Is that okay? Good, because I was going to do it anyway. But I'm going to teach today because usually I like preaching. I get all hype and, you know, I'm like yelling and spitting and stuff. But tonight, I want to teach you something because I believe that what I'm going to teach you tonight is actually going to revolutionize the way you live the rest of your life. And it is something that is important to me. Matter of fact, one of these days I'm going to write a book on what I'm going to tell you guys about today because it's so important to me. And so are you guys ready? Are you guys ready to dive into this? You guys ready? You guys ready? Okay. If you're sitting next to somebody who's going to distract you, just turn to them and just look at them. Give them that glare. Give them that glare. Say, don't make me slap you. Don't interrupt me. I got to listen. Okay. God, we thank you so much for tonight. We're going to have a good time tonight. And so, God, I bless you and I thank you. Speak through me and speak to them and to me at the same time. In Jesus' name, somebody's going to get healed tonight. If you need to get healed, raise your hand. God, we just ask that you would just give healing in our bodies right now, Lord God, that you would heal elbows, you would heal stomachs, you would heal allergies. Lord God, that you would heal eyesight. People with glasses, Lord God, would just be spontaneously healed. Lord God, I ask that the shape of their eyes would begin to change right now in the name of Jesus. Lord God, that people that are having problems in their shoulder blade, Lord God, that you would heal that. And knee problems right now, God, if there's any pain, if there was an injury, God, would you heal it in Jesus' name? Amen. What I'm going to tell you is important because it's the difference between life and death. One time God was talking to the people of Israel, the Jewish people, and he said to them, he said, I'm putting before you a choice. You can choose life or you can choose death. And then he gives them the answer, choose life. Right? So it's like you've got true, you got false, choose true. You know, and it's like the teacher gives you the answer to the test. So he goes, choose life. And right now, what I'm going to talk to you guys about is the difference between life and death. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 3. Let's put that up. It says this: by faith we understand that the worlds, that word worlds is talking about the universe. It's the world we live in. It's the universes, the stars, the galaxies. The worlds were framed by the word of God so that the things which are seen were not made by things which are visible. How many of you guys are confused? That's all right. I'm going to explain it. That's why I'm teaching today and not preaching. Here's what it says. We believe, this is what we believe as Christians, that God spoke. So in the Bible it says, in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth. And he spoke and it came into existence. God said, let there be light, and there was light. He said words, and because he said words, physical things were created. That's why it says the things which we see, like this, like this, like this, like you, like me, the things which we see were not made by things that are visible. Meaning this. How many of you guys can see God right now? No, right. He's not visible. Exactly. He's not visible. And so God spoke. How many of you guys can see your words? Can you see your words? No, because they're not visible. Exactly. You're getting it. No, you're not. And so they're not visible. So what God spoke, which is invisible, created what we do see. So is anybody still confused? You got it? All right, what God said created something that we can see. God's words created what we can see. God's word created the natural world that we see. Why is this important? This is important because you have to realize that your words have creative power. Meaning that when you say something, the invisible words that come out of your mouth will then create something in your reality. Everything that you say is building something. So if you're saying the wrong thing, you're using the wrong materials. Okay? So one of the things about living in the United States that is really cool, but then some people find bothersome, is that we have a lot of regulations when it comes to building things. Now, some people who build things go, the regulations are way too just far, and there's too many regulations. But when you're in the middle of an earthquake, you're really happy for those regulations because it's what keeps a building from falling down. If you look in other countries like Haiti, there was an earthquake in Haiti a long time ago. It wasn't a couple years ago. And everything just fell. Boom. It just crumpled to the ground. Millions of people died because there are no, there's no policies on what you use to build or how you build it. The materials that they used were not the right materials to create something that would stand in the middle of a storm. So if you are speaking words that are building something, you need to make sure that what you are building is something that will stand in the middle of a storm. You need to make sure that your words are powerful enough and the right thing to be used to stand when these things come. And I'm going to tell you how this happens because in the middle of a storm, in an even if situation, what are you saying? What are you building with your mouth? I need three. You three, please come up here. All right, pick a spot here. Pick a spot here. All right, you're there. You get to wear my hat, and go ahead. Put on. I need you. You know, she's here, so you're over here. You're over here. I need one more person. Yeah, you put that wig on. Whatever's in your section, you put it on. Whatever's in your section, you put it on. What I need to do? We got three. Zach, come up here, bro. Come up here. Okay, put that on. There you guys put on your nose. Where's you got your nose on? Here, put this on. Put this on. Yep. Mm-hmm. And this. Okay. All right. Okay. All right. Oh, okay. Here we go. Here we go. I'm loving this. This is fantastic. All right. Now, many of you may have heard the story of the three little pigs. But maybe you never knew their name. This is pessimistic pig. This is positive pig. And this is powerful pig. Now, they speak in different ways, but all of them will enter into a situation where the wolf comes ready to blow their house down. My question to you is this: which pig are you? Which pig are you? You need to figure out which pig you are because if you're the wrong pig, now how many of you guys already know the outcomes of these pigs? You guys have all heard the story. Now, let's talk to pessimistic pig here. Go ahead and pick up your materials. Yep, right here. Those are your building materials. Well, no, just go ahead and stand up. This is straw. And pessimistic pig here always has something negative to say about her life. And it could sound something like this: man, nobody ever likes me. All my friends, they go hang out with other people, and they just leave me hanging. And all of a sudden, I found about it on Instagram. I see them all there smiling. I'm sitting here in my bedroom crying because I just saw them smiling. You know what? I have the worst family in the world. Nobody has a worse family than I do. My family is the worst family. I am so stupid. I can't get an A if I tried. And I don't try, because if I did try, I get an F anyway. So why should I even try? My life is just the most horrible, the most, it's just the worst life you could ask for. And this is the life that she leads, and this is the way she builds her house. All these things. You have to understand this. When she talks, this is what comes out. This is what comes out, and this is what she has to build her house. Now, we all know that when the wolf shows up, come on, Mr. Wolf. When the wolf shows up and life gets hard, and people are like, hey, listen, you're going to be okay. Everything's going to be all right. What do you think comes out of her mouth? More of this. Because it's what she's built her house with. So when the wolf comes and the hard times start blowing. Oh yeah. She needs a harder life problem than that. That was just a failed pop quiz. That was just a failed pop quiz. But get something else. Oh yeah, there we go. There we go. Now when that happens, all that she has to rebuild her house with is the same material. And so she's like, well, of course this happened to me. It's my life. This is the way my life goes all the time. You know what? Everything happens to me. You ever meet those people? Everything happens to me. They drop their phone, the screen cracks. It's always me. It's always me. It's like, sorry, I didn't realize you were the only person in the whole entire world who ever had a cracked screen. I'm sorry, I didn't realize that you were the only person in the whole entire world who ever had friend problems. I'm sorry, I didn't realize you were the only person in the whole entire world who ever had an issue with their life, because guess what? You're not. But you think you are, because when you look at your house and what's around you, all you have to look at is what you've been speaking into it. Have a seat, pessimistic pig. Go ahead and put on your little peace sign things. Oh yeah, those are all yours. Go ahead. Now stand up as you do this. This here's positive pig. How many of you guys think positive pig is, this is the way to go, positive pig? Positive pig. Positive pig, you know, bro. Positive pig's always positive with life. Guys, you just got to stay positive all the time, guys. Hey, listen. All you got to do is just speak kindly to the universe. Universe will speak kindly to you, guys. So, here's the deal. You just got to stay chill, bro. Just stay chill, you know. Just, like, make sure everything's jiving with nature. And everything's going to be all right. Just stay positive. Just let your karma make sure that it's not rubbing off on somebody else's karma. And then make sure that you're doing good stuff. And then go ahead. Just, here, grab some of your materials here. There you go. Just grab some of those. And then she, you know, this pig, I'm not sure why she sounds like a dude, but, you know, this pig's just really positive about everything. And so she's over here. She's just building her house. And she's like, listen, you just got to stay positive. And just like, how come we're always positive all the time? Cuts, bro, you know? If you don't, man, you're just going to be down all the time, bro. I don't want to be down. I want to make everybody just feel good, bro. But then, come on. The problem is that even though words are powerful, and when you speak positively, it carries more strength than when you speak negatively. I need you guys to understand that. When people talk about like positive speaking and speaking positively, it does work. Because the reality is that there is power in your words. So when you speak positively, there is still weight to your words, because that's the way God made it to be. The problem ends up with what your word is rooted in. Because right now, positive pig's word is rooted in positive pig. So if anything happens to positive pig, come on, Mr. Wolf, blow something down. Positive pig's breath, I mean, Mr. Wolf's breath has hands. There you go. Thank you. Thank you for not chipping the cement. I appreciate that. So when the storm comes, for a while, positive pig can hold on. And you will. You will. You'll find people, and they're like, just got to stay positive. Just got to stay positive. You ever meet those people? Just got to stay positive. But eventually, they start to, like, lose that shine. You know, just got to stay positive, bro. Just got to stay positive. It's going to be okay. It's going to be okay. Again, listen to me. It will work for a while, because the principles of God stay the same. There is power in words, and you are speaking positively, and there is more strength in what is positive than is negative. And so for a while, you're going to be able to hold on. You're going to keep going, you know what? Things are going to get better. It's going to be okay. Everything's going to be all right. Life is going to get better. Things are going to happen. Things are going to go my way eventually. But then eventually, you don't have anything that you're hoping in besides the hope that something might happen. And then you're stuck. and then your whole house gets blown down. Have a seat, positive. Then you've got powerful pig. Powerful pig has a relationship with Jesus. Powerful pig is coming to 418 on Wednesdays. She's got the hat. Powerful pig is going to church on Sundays. Powerful pig is hanging out with other people that believe in Jesus and encourage her. Powerful pig is speaking the word of God over her life. See, for powerful pig, it's not just about speaking positively, but speaking positively with something to back it up. And when positive pig speaks positively with something to back it up, all of a sudden we start to get some weight to our words. And it's more than just what we think, and it's more than just, you're going to get a workout, don't worry. It's more than, do you want to balance it out so both of your arms are okay? There we go. Don't want to get lopsided. Nobody wants lopsided biceps. When you begin to speak the word of God over your life, then when the hard times come, what you are speaking is based on the King of Kings. It's based on the creator of the universe. It's based on the word of God, which has been around for thousands of years. It has not changed. It has not faltered. People all over the earth has tried to get rid of this book to destroy these words, but they can't because they're supernatural. They're powerful. They have the ability to change your mind, to change your life, to change the way you live. And when you speak the word of God over your life, it changes everything. And then, when the wolf comes, hit him with that brick. I'm just kidding. I was going to have you hit it with a brick, but then I was like, that might cause problems at home. Put the bricks down. When the wolf comes, not only do you have a building to protect yourself, but you have ammunition. See, not only do you have bricks to build your building, but now all of a sudden, anybody ever seen Home Alone? All of a sudden, you have ammunition too. And when the wolf comes, you're like, excuse me, wolf, I don't know if you know who I follow, but his name is Jesus, and he's the King of Kings. And all of a sudden, wolf doesn't want to stand around trying to bully you anymore. Give these people a hand. Go ahead, have a seat. What are you building in your life? See, some of you guys have been messing with this so long, you don't even know how to build a different house. Some of you guys, my family's never going to get better. It's just the way it is, the way it's always been. Never can expect anything better than this. Just the way my family is, the way my life is. Well, better get used to it. Some of you guys have been spending your time with this. And I entitled this message, and I want you to write this down because sometimes you're going to have to remind yourself to do this. The title of this message is Shut Up and Say Something. Shut up and say something. Turn to two neighbors, say, shut up and say something. Here's what I'm talking about. You need to shut up with this. And you need to say something. You need to stop building your life with the straw of negativity and start building your life with the word of God. Not just positivity, because it's not grounded in truth all the time, but in the word of God, because it's grounded in the truth. You need to start building your relationships with your friends with your words. You need to start building your family with your words. You need to start building your future with your words. You need to start building your health with your words. You need to start building the fact that you are valuable with your words. Many of us have been using our words to build the wrong house, and I'm saying, shut up and say something. Shut up and say something that is grounded in the Word of God. Some of you guys want to do things with your life that if you continue in the direction you are, you'll never make it there. And the reason why you stay in that rut is because you've been speaking this rut. Maybe I'll say it this way. The reason why you've been living in that house is because you've been speaking this house. You've been speaking the house of, I can't. I cannot stand those words. I can't. I'm like, that is, when I say it, it bugs me. Anybody like Walt Disney stuff? Colton, he got me this book from Disney World, and it was called The Imagineer's Workbook. And it's all their creative people and stuff they do to stay creative. And one of the things that they talked about was verbiage and the way you use your words. And nobody is allowed to say, we can't do that. Meaning nobody is allowed to put a cap on what you can do. The only thing that you can do is say, we can do that if. Meaning instead of saying, that's impossible, you say, it's possible if this were to happen. Now, this may seem like an impossible thing, but it's still possible if that happened. See, because the way you word things affects the way your mind comprehends them. So when you start just saying, I can't, in the middle of a test, your brain goes, oh, you're right, and it shuts down. That's what happens. Your brain shuts down. Your brain responds to you. I know a lot of us think that we respond to our brain, but we don't. Because you're not your brain. You are you. God made you spirit, soul, and body, which means that your body is actually responding to your spirit and your soul and not the other way around. See, God didn't come and say, hey, listen, I'm going to make a body and then I'm going to stick a spirit and a soul in it. He said, I'm going to make a spirit and a soul and wrap a body around it. You are affecting what you can see with what you don't see, namely your words. So you need to start speaking into your schoolwork and say, you know what? Math isn't impossible. Science isn't impossible. English isn't impossible. Some of you guys just need to say history isn't boring because you're saying it is, and then when you go into class, your brain shuts down and you can't get it, and you wonder why you can't remember what's supposed to be going on. What you are saying with your mouth is creating realities in your head. Some of you guys are thinking, well, I'll never get a boyfriend. I'll never get a girlfriend that's as good as blah, blah, blah. Of course you're not, because you're speaking the reality into your life. So when you go into a possible relationship, you will lower yourself to the standard you've spoken over yourself. A couple years ago, we did something called Christmas Jam. Anybody remember that? And Christmas Jam was basically, it was like a big party, and we invited people. And I was asking God, I'll say, God, I want to see 100 people come. I want to see 100 people come. And God goes, okay. And I was asking the Lord, and I was like, I was nervous because we'd spent a lot of money, and I was like, Lord, I need to see 100 people. And so the Lord goes, I want you to picture 100 people there. And I was trying in my head to picture 100 people, and I was like, I can't picture past like 60 people in my head. He goes, You have to picture 100 people. And so I was like, okay. And so I'm picturing in my head, and I pictured 100 people. I just forced it. I just forced myself to picture 100 people. And then I began to speak it. We're going to see 100 people tonight. And I began to picture it. We're going to see 100 people. And I spoke into reality. And that night, we were getting towards the night starting. And Kristen comes up to me and she goes, we have 100 people. And I was like, hallelujah! And I was just like, I was like so pumped up. I was like, yes, yes. It didn't matter what happened the rest of the night. The whole building could have burned down. I'd be like, it doesn't matter. We got 100 people. Jesus came through. Hallelujah. I mean, it was like incredible. But there was something about me speaking into existence what I wanted to see happen. And God knew that there was power in my words, so he had to have me see it so that I could speak it, so it become reality. Some of you guys want to get a certain career and go to a certain college and different things like that. But you're going, I can't do that. I can't get into that. I can't do this. Well, no, you can't. Because you've spoken that into reality. And God wants you to change what you're building. But remember this. You can't just start saying, well, good things happen when you speak positively. You just got to talk to the universe. Guess what? The universe doesn't care about you. You know why? Because it's not alive. I'm so serious right now. Listen, guys. God made the universe. And he made you in his image. Why are we waiting for the universe to respond when the God who created the universe is waiting to be in a relationship with you? And he's given us the promises in his word. Let me tell you real quick how this works. When we speak positively, we have the force of our words behind it, the power of our words behind it that God created people to be able to have. It's powerful. But when we speak God's word with our words, then the power of our words joins with the power of God's word, and all of a sudden, anything that stands in your way gets pushed back. Anything that you couldn't do before on your own, now through Christ you can do all things. Anything that you didn't think was possible, now it's possible because your power has joined with the power of God and he can do anything. Anything is possible for those who believe. Who believe in what? In the power of the universe and the positivity of words? No, who believe in the power of God and his ability to take you into your destiny. This is it. See, let me tell you guys something. This is why I'm saying it's the difference between life and death, because if you continually live your life building this, this is all you will ever have. And when the storms come, your house will blow down. It's time to shut up and say something. So we're going to practice. You guys ready to practice? You guys ready to practice? We're gonna speak some stuff over some stuff, and I'm gonna teach you how you do this. But before we do that, I want to say this. You need to be continually speaking over your life. Now, you guys all know the story of the three little pigs, right? You guys have, you know, somewhat of it. Before the wolf came, the house was built. Okay? The wolf didn't show up and then they started building their house, meaning this. You can't wait for a hard time to start speaking the word of God. You need to be speaking the word of God over your life before anything hard ever happens. Do you know there are times when I will think about things in my life and I will go, God, if this thing ever happened to me, I would still serve you. If this ever happened to me, and I'll just go through things. That's not morbid. It's not like one of these things, oh, God, if I'm a burn victim. It's not like that. But I've used it. I said that, God, because sometimes you ever see pictures of things that have happened to people and it's horrible? And you're like, I don't know if I can handle that. I don't say that. Well, I don't say it the second time. I may look at it and go, I don't know if I could do it. But then I go, God, if that ever happened to me, I'd still follow you. If that ever happened to me, I'd still put a smile on my face. If that ever happened to me, I'd still worship you. If that ever happened to me, and it's not something I just kind of like, okay, now it's time to practice. What would I do if? You know, it's just like, as things come up, God, what would I do in this situation? You know what, God, I would still serve you. What would happen in worst case scenario here? I would still serve you. I would still love you. I would still tell people about you. You need to be speaking and building your life before it happens. So let's practice this. Let's say you wake up tomorrow morning and you open your eyes, and I just want you guys to repeat after me. Say, good morning, Jesus. Thank you for loving me. I don't deserve it. You're amazing. You think I'm awesome. Even on my bad days, You think I'm awesome. You love me. You died on the cross for me. Even when I sin, you still forgive me. You'll never leave me. You'll never fail me. You'll never stop loving me. And whatever comes my way, today, we can handle it. And then you go into your day. And something does come your way, like somebody eats the last of the syrup and there's pancakes left, but there ain't no syrup left, you know what I'm saying? I know there's more serious things in the world, but right at that moment, there is not. Right at that moment, the most serious thing in the world right now is the fact that there is no syrup for these pancakes, and I got to use jelly. What is the problem? Now, let's just say real stuff does happen. Real stuff happens in your life. Problem with friends, drama, this, that, whatever. You go, you know what? I can't handle this with God. We're going to get through this. We're going to get through this. Me and Jesus, we got this. Now, here's some things I want you guys to start doing just on a regular basis. The Lord keeps dropping stuff in my head, and that's why I'm teaching, not preaching. That's why I'm kind of interrupting myself. I want to explain something to you. You can be trying to build this, and someone will try to give you this. You will be saying, God's got a plan for me. God's going to do great things through me. And then somebody's going to walk up and say to you, why don't you just tone it down a little bit? Listen, your family's never had money. Your parents never had money. You're never going to have any money. I know, listen, none of us has ever gone to college. Nobody in our family has ever gone to college. You're probably not going to go to college either. Listen, I know you want to be a professional musician, but listen, the odds are not in your favor. Okay? Listen, I know that you would like to be an artist, but most artists are starving. You know, I mean, just they come in here. And anybody ever know somebody like that? Maybe that's not the exact thing, but they come in like, hey, listen, I'm not trying to be negative Nelly here, but I just want to be a voice of reason. No, you're not. You're trying to throw straw in my bricks. And you know what? It is your choice whether you add them to your house or not. Always remember that. Say, this is my house. This is my house. And I pick the decor. And I don't want your straw in my house. Now, you may not say that to the person's face, but when they walk away, you might need to say it a couple times. This is my house. I decide what goes in my house. And something my wife and I will do when we're around a really negative person. And you feel gross after being around somebody just like, it's just nasty. And we just wash each other off. We're just like, Lord, we just wash that off. We wash off that negativity. We wash off just the stuff. And we don't need their straw in our building. You have the right to decide what your building is made out of. Okay, back to my other point. Stand up. We're going to speak some stuff. Let's speak some stuff over our families. You guys ready? Let's speak some stuff over our families. Say this, my family. My family belongs to me. Doesn't belong to the devil. Doesn't belong to addiction. Doesn't belong to divorce. It doesn't belong to unfaithfulness. My family belongs to me because I'm the one who has Jesus on the inside. And wherever I walk, God gives it to me. And when I walk in my house, it belongs to me. I love my parents. I forgive my parents. And I release my parents. My family has a future. My family has a hope. And God has good things planned for my family. So that's the stuff you start saying. What is that based off of? All that stuff that I'm saying is based off of Scripture. When I said, when you walk into your house, that it belongs to you, that's in Joshua. And God said to Joshua, wherever you walk, I'll give it to you. He said to Abraham, wherever you walk, I will give it to you. The Bible says that you are actually a spiritual authority because you have Jesus on the inside of you. And so you have the ability to declare with your mouth the future of your family. God does not have bad things planned for anyone on his. God has good things planned for everyone. It's just the choice of whether they're going to take it. And you're going to start speaking those choices over your family. Let's speak over our health. You guys ready? Say, God, thank you for this body you gave me. Ooh, the Lord just said like this. When you don't like your body, you invite in sickness. Meaning this, when you start complaining about your body and who you are, what happens is the enemy goes, okay, you don't like it, I'll take it. When we reject what God has given, it no longer has anyone to hold it and protect it. God is saying that we need to stop saying, I don't like me, because God gave it to us, and he's saying, listen, I will bless you when you bless yourself. Just start speaking over yourself. Say, I am healthy. I am well. God has given me authority over myself. I speak health. I speak wellness over my body. Just start speaking over that thing in the morning. You wake up, maybe you have a thing going on. You start speaking over it. God has not given me a spirit of fear, but of power and love. God has not given me a spirit of sickness, but of health. God has said that he wants to heal. He wants to set free and deliver. And that is true for me too. And you just start speaking over yourself. Let me tell you something. This is why you need to read your Bible. Because you will not know the truth that God has for you. And you'll just be guessing, well, I'm sure that the Lord wants this for my life, because why not? Well, you're not sure. Go find the Bible. Read what it says in the Bible. It will tell you what God has for your life. Let's do a couple other things. Let's just do this last one, your future. Say, God gave me this life. It's only one. I will not be reincarnated. I will not come back as a pig. This is the life I have to live. And it's a good one. It may be hard, but I will overcome, because I'm an overcomer. Jesus is making me like him, and he's a conqueror. So I'm a conqueror. I will choose to be a conqueror. God knows the plans he has for me. They're plans to prosper me, not to harm me. Their plans to give me a future and a hope. You guys, just start speaking this stuff over yourself. Just start speaking this stuff over yourself. Say this. What my family has had in the past does not have to be my future. What my family has had in the past does not have to be my future. Can I tell you, this is why I don't understand why anybody would not want to follow Jesus. Because if you're not following Jesus, you're following yourself. You may have a plan for your life, but you don't know the beginning from the end of your life. You may know what is making you happy in the moment, but God knows what will make you happy in the future. You need to be connected with the one who has a plan for you, and it's always a good one. No matter what you go through, the destination is always great. So we follow Jesus. Let's close your eyes real quick. Can you just say, thank you, Jesus, for your promises, for your word, for your truth? Real quick, if you've never given your life to Jesus, if you've never said, Jesus, I've been living life my own way, I want to live life your way, I want to give you my life, and I don't know exactly what that looks like, but it's better than what I got right now. If you've never done that before and you want to for real, would you just raise your hand up? Would you just raise your hand? I want to give my life to Jesus. Good. Good. Anybody else? Anybody else? Anybody else? Good leaders, would you just look? If there's a hand up, just go to them. There's going to be a leader that's going to go to you. They're going to pray with you. They're going to give you a Bible. I'm going to pray over you right now. God, I thank you for these students. Lord, I thank you that even if life gets hard, we're going to follow you. Come on, we're going to declare it. Even if life gets hard, I'm going to follow Jesus. It could become almost unbearable, but I'll stick with Jesus because I know he'll stick in my boat and he'll get me to the other side. I can trust him and he'll never leave me. I can hope in him and he'll never fail me. So we give you our lives and we follow you, Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen.